In a brief communication published in 1865, Theodore Nicholas Gill named a new species of tapir from specimens collected in Panama. He named it after the Smithsonian's first curator, Spencer Fullerton Baird. Baird's tapir is one of more than 40 species named for Baird as a tribute to his achievements. He was a giant in science. As a boy, Baird developed an intense interest in nature, and he took long hikes through the woods with his older brother William, who liked to study birds. They collected and examined specimens in their home state of Pennsylvania, and through self-study and help from experts such as John James Audubon, Baird became a young naturalist with a reputation. He was a disciplined young man, and he developed work habits that shaped his career. He wrote nearly 10 letters a day on average. People say Baird was industrious, gentle, never arguing. Most conspicuously, he could never be persuaded to give public speeches. His kind temperament won people over. He had a big personality and maintained an impressive network of relationships, including many collectors. He thought it was important to collect and study specimens before species disappeared. He was the force behind the Smithsonian becoming the nation's museum. When Baird started here in 1850, the Smithsonian had 6,000 natural history specimens. When he passed away in 1887, the Smithsonian's collection had grown to 2.5 million artifacts and specimens.